It's almost 6 a.m., and we've been here all night, and it is worth it to be here all night to stand up for people's charter rights, to protect our local democracy, and to stand with the people of Ontario. So the members...
Stop the clock. The House will come to order. I realize that it might be almost 6 o'clock, and we've been here a long time, but the member has the right to make comments, and the rest of us have the right to sit quietly and give him the opportunity. Return to the member.
Mr. Speaker, thank you. I wish the members opposite would have the same passion for people's charter rights as we have just heard from the member from Ottawa-Vanier. We just heard a passionate defense of people's charter rights. I am deeply concerned, Madam Speaker, of the words and the actions I've heard from the Premier and I've heard from the House Leader earlier tonight, or this morning, I should say. They essentially are saying that they believe the members of this House can act with impunity. A majority government, which I remind you, was only elected by 40% of the electors and only 23% of eligible voters. And they suggest that they can act with impunity and are above the rule of law. Well, we live in a constitutional democracy where laws are respected, where courts are respected, and that is the thin line between a functioning democracy and chaos and dysfunction. So it's the Premier's actions that have led to the dysfunction that we are now seeing in the Toronto election, that are leading to questions around the very legitimacy of Toronto's election. And I would like to know how many tax dollars are going to be wasted litigating all of the actions of this Premier. Thank you.